if I take a look at Auston Matthews, he's always at the right place at the right time, and he's just that's it. He gets the job done. There's not a lot of flash. The puck gets on a stick. It's going in the net.
Well, he's overpowering now, Frank. He handles the puck so well, you can't take it from him.
He's a great skater, and it's exactly, he has a great eye-hand coordination, and he gets along good with his stick.
Right. And you mentioned...
That's what Pipe Ben was saying. Yeah. That stick is a part of his being.
Yeah.
I mean, he handles it like it's a toy.
Right. And Frank, you brought up Connor McDavid. Do you believe that a year ago we'd be having the same conversation, especially after what the Oilers are doing? They won last night in Detroit. That was a huge win for them. But they, oh, my God, look at their record. Would you believe that we're having the same conversation we had a year ago? That right now, Connor McDavid and Auston Matthews are in the same sentence for as far as talent and quality?
Yeah, I always thought that Auston Matthews...
Better than McDavid?
I always thought that he was in the same... I said that last year. I think one of the guys in the panel kind of, argued with me, but Bill Waters never argued with me, or did Phil Esposito. We talked about when Auston Matthews came to Toronto. Do you remember the conversation we had, Bill? And Phil Esposito, this was before you came onto the panel, John, and we were talking about how much parity there was in the two players.
Wow. But I honestly think in as a whole, in the NHL and hockey, I think that's an anomaly. A lot of people didn't think they'd compare them at this time.
I agree with you there, John, but I recall telling Frank and Phil the story about Mark Crawford, who's a good pal of mine and a good pal of some of yours, I'm sure, too.
Yep.
But we were talking about the draft before the Leafs took Matthews. And I said, well, Crow, you had him there. He said, oh, yeah, Bill. He said, he's a wonderful player. He said, don't you repeat this before the draft, but I think he's every bit as good as Connor McDavid.
How about that?
And I
realized he was in a special category.
But I actually think that Auston Matthews is a much stronger player as far as strength, brute force, physical strength, than Connor McDavid.
And fast. I didn't think he was that fast.
No, Connor McDavid's faster. Connor McDavid,
Jesus.
I would say, is a skater in the NHL.
But Matthews is a lot faster than I thought.
Matthews is very fast, but
yeah.
I would give the edge, pardon the pun, to Connor McDavid on skating.
And remember, the Leafs...
On speed, on getaway, but where Matthews has the edge is when the playoffs start. This guy can play at both ends of the ice, and he can play the big boys.
Yeah, and he's a clutch player.
Well, he is a big boy, and you just verified my statement is that out of the three players, the Tavares, Connor McDavid, and Auston Matthews, out of these three guys, three super elite players, you would say they're super elite players, yes or no, Bill?
Yeah, the difference between, as I see, Tavares and Matthews right now. Let's project Matthews ahead 7 years, and he's playing. Matthews is a better skater than John Tavares.
100%. But Tavares is a super elite player, and again, I put Matthews on top of Tavares and Connor McDavid on physical strength. He's physically stronger than both of them.
Well, I don't know that, Frank. I know this. He's quicker off the dart, off the line. McDavid's got better breakaway speed, but he's not a better skater than Matthews. He's a better skater than Tavares. But that Tavares kid, somebody's going to get a free agent next year, and they're going to build a franchise around him.
I agree with you 100,000,000%. A team like Las Vegas would eat up a guy like him. He would become the superstar there. And I think that Vegas already has started off with an incredible fucking foundation for a team. They got strong management. The ownership has very deep pockets. And I would say, I'm not alluding that I've read anything or I'm gossiping. I'm just making an observation that if a guy like Tavares went to play in Vegas and they would build that whole franchise around him, they would pave their way to the Stanley Cup much earlier than their forecast.
Right.